In today's video about the FNC Data Grid, I'm going to show you how you can set up your data sets bound in a master detail configuration together with the FNC Data Grid to have a master detail relationship within the FNC Data Grid shown. So we are going to show you the scenario where we have the master data set shown in the grid with a grid in a grid showing the detailed data set in the subgrid. Let's dive in the Delphi IDE and let's have a look at all these things in detail. So let's jump right into it in our Delphi 12 IDE, and I'm going to show you this setup really step by step. That's why we are starting from a new, brand new VCL application from scratch. And what we are going to do is, of course, add the data grid on the form. This will be our master grid. And to perform the binding of our master grid to the master table, we need the database adapter. This is the database adapter, which sits between our data set, data source, and our data grid. So I'm going to use for this example an ADO table, an access database that has tables with the master detail relationship built in. So I'm binding the data set to the data source, I'm binding the data source to the data adapter, and I'm picking the database, the ADO table, like this. Let's pick the right access file. This is it. And the master table will be the customer table. So I select from table name the customer table. When I now activate this data set, we should already see at design time the database, the table customers in our FNC data grid. And now we are going to set up the detail grid and bind the detail grid as a detail control into our master grid. So therefore we add a secondary data grid on the form, which will be our detail grid. I add it here, and we are going to specify in our master grid database adapter that this second grid is our detail control. Note that we are using as a detail control here another database grid, but we could add actually any other DB aware control or controls that have or host other DB controls as the detail control for our master grid. The only difference is that here, when I open up the record, click it open in the master grid, it will show us the detail grid, but it could show us, for example, also another control as detail control in the master grid. But here, this demo focuses on a grid in grid relationship. Now, I need to bind our detail grid to our detail data source, and therefore I need another database adapter that sits between our detail data set. So I add another data source for that, and another ADO table that will link to the detail table. So this is table 2. Let's hook these all up. I add the data source, the data set to the data source, and the data source to the data adapter. And of course, I need to link the database adapter to the detail grid. The only thing left to do now is set up our ADO table. So I'm using the connection string for that and bind it to the same access database that has the detail table. And I pick the detail table via table name. This will be the orders table. And now what I need to do is make the binding between the master table and the detail table. I can do that directly via the master fields property and master source property in our detail table. The link between master and detail is based on the customer number field in both tables, and this way it has been added. When I now activate my second table, the detail table, you can see that it already shows the fields in this second table. Now, this should be complete. Let's see it in action when I run this application. So we see the master grid. It has all data on board. And now when I open up this master record, I see the detail grid in the grid. So we have this expected grid in grid scenario for our master detail relationship. And you can see that both in our master grid and the detail grid, we can perform editing on these master table, detail table. All this without writing a single line of code. You have this master detail functionality all right and ready for you in the new FNC Data Grid.